decide matter all of you, please.
I'm not deciding this stuff.
KLS or
Rohit? Okay, don't believe
me. Leave that
body. Get to know
some
question.
Okay, so now I'm starting the class. Okay, so today's plan is Say for example, a paper ball, okay? Let's say we have a paper ball. Or a better example would be a paper paper cup.
Plastic
disposable cup. If you drop it, okay, you'll find that it will reach terminal velocity after some time. Okay, if you drop a paper cup, it will have some mass due to which it will have a weight. So already you know what is weight. Meaning, I did not teach it you separately as a new concept. Weight is the gravitational force with which the earth pulls an object having mass m towards its center. And earth pulls an object with this gravitational force using something called as the field. Okay, so the small letter G is the gravitational field. So if this gravitational field has a value at every point in space, the further you go from the earth, the weaker the value of this field. And so the weight of the object will become more or less as you go further
away. So what was your definition of weight?
Once again, can you get one more black marker? New one. Yes.
So how do you determine the gravitational field?
Note down the definition, please. So weight is m into g, where g is the gravitational field at the location You can see the video. I have uploaded all the videos in the YouTube channel.
So we don't understand.
YouTube channel? When you sit around so that you can see
the video.
If you
can't do it right now. If
the phone is not even recording your video, how are you going to upload it?
Arey, it is recording.
It is recording, man.
Aadi to dance the
bata
hai.
And if you can't see that,
Samsung. Aadi charge the Samsung.
So the gravitational field varies from place to place. This g value is right now taken to be at surface of Earth, and at surface of Earth, which is at a fixed distance from the center of the Earth, which is equal to radius of the Earth, that distance, okay, the value of this field turns out to be 9.8 meter per second square. So this G is 9.8 meter per second square. Now don't let the unit of the gravitational field confuse you and make you think that it is same as acceleration due to gravity. Acceleration due to gravity is not gravitational field. Acceleration is acceleration. It just tells you if there is a net force acting on an object, at what rate its velocity will change. That is acceleration. And acceleration due to gravity refers to the case of free fall. Free fall means if something is falling under the influence of only gravitational force. Note that down also, that definition. Free fall refers to motion under the influence of only gravitational force. That means if you draw free body diagram of an object in free fall, the only force acting on it would be mg downwards, nothing else. That means F net would be mg, the net force would be mg, and by Newton's second law, if you equate it to mass times acceleration, acceleration would be equal to g. So only when an object is in free fall, okay, the acceleration of that object would be numerically equal to gravitational field. That does not mean they are same.
So in this
just
condition,
because two different boys have same name, it doesn't make them same.
So
yes.
So in this condition, it's the same, right?
In which condition?
Paper cup falling.
This condition, I haven't drawn all the forces. There will be air resistance acting upwards, which we call
as friction. If it's a hollow cup.
Whether it's hollow or not, air resistance is significant for a paper cup. The reason being, air resistance is somewhat weaker force, and the weight of the paper cup is also less.
So, but it's still.
So, air resistance, which itself is less, is a significant fraction of the weight of the paper cup. So, it will affect the net force significantly. So that the acceleration will be affected. But if I draw a metal box, okay, compared to the weight of the metal box, the air resistance is very less. It's like 1%, let us say. So the change in the acceleration due to air resistance will be negligible.
But say in vacuum, if you throw them from a particular
so vacuum, there is no air resistance. So it would be this equation which
yes.
is acting. So that's why you see here, the acceleration of an object in free fall does not depend on the mass. You see that?
Yes, sir.
The weight is equal to mass times acceleration.
Acceleration
so mass gets cancelled out. Acceleration only depends on the gravitational field.
I have a question.
If you want to wait 1 second, the best way to understand it conceptually is acceleration is more if the force acting on the object is more. That is one point. But then to produce more acceleration, it becomes difficult if the mass of that object is also more. Are you getting it? So if you take an elephant. And a feather, okay, and drop it in vacuum. Obviously, the weight of feather is very less. Weight of elephant is very large.
So they will fall at the same
okay. time. But the force required to make it accelerate at the value of a is also very less for a feather. Feather requires very less force to cause it an acceleration of a, and elephant requires a lot of force to cause the same acceleration of A. Are you getting it? So that large force required to give an acceleration of A to elephant is provided by the large weight, and the small force required to give an acceleration of A to the feather is provided by the
small
weight of the feather.
So is this in vacuum?
So sir,
is this same in vacuum?
Yeah, this is
same.
So sir.
Yeah.
So according to this, so the feather should fall before the elephant
in
normal conditions, not in vacuum.
In normal conditions,
because it is requiring very less force.
But the force
given to both the objects is same.
No, how is it same? mass of feather is less, the gravitational force acting on the feather is less, the gravitational force acting on the elephant is more. In addition to these two forces in air, when they are falling in air, there will be air resistance which will provide the friction force. So for feather also it will be small force, for elephant it may be somewhat bigger because it has bigger area of cross section. But still the friction is very less or negligible compared to the weight of the elephant.
The air resistance is the only factor affecting the fall.
Yeah.
In vacuum.
Not in vacuum, in normal conditions.
I'm asking, is this the mass, does it is it on vacuum or the
listen carefully please. You have to listen without interruption, otherwise you will get confused what we are talking about. Listen, if you drop an elephant and a feather in vacuum, the net force equation would be just mg equals ma for each case, m will cancel in each case, a will be equal to g. That means the acceleration of elephant will also be g, acceleration of feather will also be g. So they will both hit the ground at the same time when they are released from same height from rest. Okay? But if you drop them in air, the air resistance will be acting upwards on both. Now compared to the downward weight of feather, the air resistance acting on the feather will be almost equal. Are you getting it? As a result, it will just fall very slowly. The acceleration will be almost zero. It will come down with constant velocity and settle down slowly. But for elephant, the friction would be negligible compared to its weight. So there would not be much change in its acceleration. It will still fall almost at zero. Okay? So now what were the questions you had done?
Sir, sir, does the earth have a charge?
We are not talking about charge right now. Anyway, the quick answer is it's a neutral body, earth is neutral. Please ask your questions only related to what I have explained. If you don't understand anything which I have explained, ask that. So then other questions you can ask later. We are right now in a hurry to finish.
That's a point of clarity.
Based on what I explained?
Yes.
Yeah.
So the man point of clarification is that the more the mass, so sir, the more the gravitation pull is applied on the
yes,
body.
Yes.
And so the reason is that
the gravitational pull is calculated as mass of that object multiplied by the field. So field is same for everything which is at the same location. So bigger mass will get bigger pull.
That's the,
now this is, you cannot ask why. In, right now in physics we are not answering why it is like this. We are only explaining what is happening. So we in science we study how nature works first. We try to observe the behavior and then we try to formulate rules which will predict the same behavior in same situation. As to why it behaves like that, you can have any number of theories. We can never prove any theory which is correct, which is wrong. You can come up with any kind of crazy theory which will give the same kind of behavior. How do you know which theory is correct? Okay? So this is just describing what is happening, what is observed. Okay. So now coming back to terminal velocity concept. Where is the rest? Okay. So now we are coming back to the concept of terminal velocity. So if you drop an object which has less weight so that the air resistance would be having a significant effect on its acceleration. The typical example is you drop a paper cup, okay? Then what will happen is, see, as it tries to fall through the air molecules are present here, we can't see them but they are very much present. Agreed? You can feel the similar kind of effect when you are on a bike. And the person who is driving the bike is driving at say 110 km per hour. I have felt it. Especially someone lightweight like Shimans, he may even fly off the bike at 110 km per hour.
No side
tight. It is not holding on too tight. If he is wearing loose, let us say loose jacket he is wearing, the air will fill up the jacket and create more thrust. Then he may get thrown off.
Or if he is
at least you can feel the force on your face, right? But if the bike is not moving, do you feel any force of the air molecules hitting your face? You don't. So as you go faster and faster and faster, you are actually hitting the air molecules with more speed. As a result, the force exerted by you on the air molecules is more. By Newton's third law, the force exerted by the air molecules on your face is also more if you speed up. So now can you understand why this air vessel is created. It's basically created due to the collision with the air molecules are blocking your way, blocking your path. So as you go forward, you're colliding against these molecules and throwing them off. Okay? Imagine a mad bull rushing through the classroom, hitting each one of you. Each time it hits one of you, you exert a force on the bull, slowing it down. Agreed? So that's what is happening. The air molecules are slowing it down by colliding with it. So faster it moves, more the force will be. So if it doesn't move, there won't be any force. Clear? So air resistance, which we call as friction here, okay, it is proportional to the speed of the object sometimes. So when it is moving smoothly through the air, like say streamlined, when the airflow passed, it is streamlined, not turbulent. It's mostly proportional to speed of the object. But if it goes too fast, it will create turbulence in the air. The air will not flow smoothly past it. It will be creating a lot of vortices,
so like
turbulence. Okay? Then it is proportional to V squared. In real life scenario, what happens is mostly it will be both effects will be happening at the same time. So the friction will be a function of speed, proportional to speed, as well as some part of the friction will be proportional to V squared.
So what acts on an airplane, sir? V squared or V?
Both effects will be there. Like we have done experiments. So when, once you come to IT, you will be doing experiments for internal assessment. So one experiment we did is the student will kick the football, okay, and observe how it moves. If there was no air resistance, it should have gone following a perfect parabolic path. If there is air resistance, what do you think will happen? Will it go further or less?
Less.
Will it go higher or less?
Less.
So both counts it will reduce, so it will go like this. You getting it? Height will also decrease, range will also decrease. So now the challenge is, for this motion, the equation is very simple, quadratic equation, parabola. But for this, the equation will become complex. So we try to predict if the effect of friction is, so what is the effect of friction? How is, what kind of friction force is acting to cause this change?
I didn't get the difference between V and V squared.
See, if the speed doubles, if friction was proportional to speed, friction would also double. But if friction is proportional to speed squared, if speed doubles, friction will become four times more. Are you getting it? The effect of friction will be much more if it's turbulent. Clear? So now the whole concept is, initially it starts with zero friction. When the paper cup starts with zero speed, friction will be zero?
Yes.
Agreed? So as it, so now the net force is only mg. So here I will draw the net force. So initially it's just mg. Then after some time, it is still mg. And friction will become somewhat more. Because speed has increased, after some time what will happen? Friction will again be mg only. I mean, weight will still be mg only, but friction will become even greater. So as a result, what will happen? So net force was initially equal to mg. This is net force equal to mg. Now net force will be shorter. It's this minus friction. This minus friction. This, if you take this direction as a, so the net force would be this minus this. Mg minus F would be shorter. Agreed or not? Let us say Mg is 5 newtons, friction is 1 newton. What would be the net force?
4
newtons.
No, sir, so it will be faster than the force.
If here it is 5 newtons, F net is also 5 newtons.
Then it becomes 4.
And so now if let us say friction is 2 newtons, mg is again 5 as before.
3.
Now it will become even
so
shorter.
So the speed keeps decreasing.
No. This
net
is where you get
speed more. Speed is increasing, the resistance is also increasing.
Yeah, friction is increasing.
Yeah, so friction is increasing, so friction cancels out the speed.
No.
Why?
I'll tell you. So F net is 3 newtons. First you need to recollect. Newton's second law talks about velocity or acceleration?
Velocity.
Acceleration. Acceleration is net force by mass. If net force decreases, acceleration decreases. That means, imagine you are driving a car. Initially, your acceleration was due to the net force of 5 newtons. So you have pressed the accelerator pedal to the maximum. So your acceleration is maximum and you start from zero speed. Okay? So let's draw the graph of velocity versus time. So this is velocity, this is time. So you start with zero speed initially, okay?
Yeah.
When you drop it, so you have pressed the accelerator to the maximum. So the slope of velocity time graph is what quantity? Slope of velocity time graph represents what quantity, Shubhya? Slope of velocity time represents what?
Sir.
No raising hands for answering. No other should not prompt. Think. Slope means change in this by change in this. So what is change in velocity by change in time? Yeah. So we have acceleration is maximum here.
I don't understand.
Yep.
And then it's decreasing. Agreed?
Yeah.
Because net force is decreasing.
Acceleration is increasing, but
acceleration is proportional to the net force. If net force is downward and decreasing, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, finally it becomes 0.
Oh my God.
Finally, when friction equals 5,
so it will stop.
Again, now you are forgetting about net force controls acceleration, not velocity. Acceleration will become 0.
But
when constant velocity,
it will
be equal. That constant velocity is called terminal velocity.
That
listen, when this mg is also 5 and friction is also 5,
so they both cancel out.
Net force will become 0.
When net force is 0, it's terminal velocity.
Implies acceleration is 0, implies the velocity is equal to terminal velocity. Whatever velocity it has had here. So remember what is happening is, you start with maximum slope. Slope is acceleration in a velocity time graph. So, but then the slope keeps decreasing. Decreasing, 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 till it becomes 0.
And that's when you reach terminal.
Yes.
Sir?
So acceleration decreases, 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 till the acceleration becomes 0. Once acceleration becomes 0, velocity will no longer change. So it keeps falling with the same speed. But throughout this duration, what was happening is, I had started with the accelerator pedal maximum depressed. So it was going as, it was speeding up as much as possible.
And then
gradually I'm releasing the accelerator pedal. So the rate at which it is speeding up is decreasing till it no longer speeds up. But throughout this time, my speed is itself increasing. Are you getting it?
The speed is decreasing.
Now again you are stuck with that.
Sir, after you deaccelerate, won't
increase. Exactly, he is not getting it.
He
needs to drive a bike.
According to my explanation,
the curve starts with zero speed, keeps on speeding up, speeding up.
But the resistance is also acting on it, na?
Yes, sir.
First calm down, think slowly, steadily, only then it will sink in. If you remain agitated, the concept won't sink in. First calm down first. Listen carefully to what I'm saying. The paper curve starts from rest. So initial speed is zero. That's what this is, the initial speed. Then it keeps increasing in speed because there is a non-zero acceleration downwards. Acceleration will cause the speed to increase. The acceleration itself is decreasing, but still there is some acceleration. It's like this. Imagine you are starting your bike. Rishikesh, please wait. Imagine you are starting the bike with accelerator full. Okay? So you start from rest. So you try to, you will be speeding up more and more and more, but then gradually you reduce the acceleration. But still your speed will keep increasing only. Finally, you make the accelerator zero. Now the speed will no longer increase, but all this while you did nothing to slow down your speed. All you did was, you reduced the effort you put in to speed up. So you will decrease the rate at which you are speeding up, but your speed itself does not decrease. So all the while your speed was increasing, 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 but it is increasing at a slower rate.
So sir, when the force applied and the resistance is cancelled out, but it, the object is still moving because of the constant velocity, that's terminal velocity.
That constant velocity, which is the maximum velocity reached by the object, is terminal velocity. So this is terminal velocity.
Question sir?
1 minute. This is called terminal velocity.
So you're giving me a definition, sir.
Yeah, so terminal velocity is the final maximum velocity attained by an object.
Final maximum velocity.
Viscous medium means a medium which provides friction.
So that's why it can't be a terminal velocity at rest because there's no friction.
Yeah. Viscous medium means any medium which provides friction to the object passing through it.
So, sir, terminal velocity.
One minute, let me finish writing it. Drag force is another name for friction. When something is trying to travel, pass through a medium, it will experience a drag force which is slowing it down. It's air resistance, water resistance, friction. Clear?
So wait.
Sir.
Yes. Restrict your question to what is based on.
Yes.
Yeah.
So if there's a submarine and there's a bike, bikes on the land and submarine in the water, so they're traveling both at the same speed. So which will attain the terminal velocity before?
Okay, see, if you think carefully, both are traveling at same speed.
Yeah, but
the friction due to the water will be more. Drag due to water should be more than air. So as the speed increases, both start from rest, let us say.
Yeah, and then
speed up at the same rate.
Speed up.
Okay, so now, if they are speeding up at the same rate, okay, but then both have different weight also, no? Motorbike has a different weight, so motorbike will achieve a terminal velocity the moment the air resistance equals the weight.
Yes.
So air resistance requires less force to cancel the weight in the case of motorbike. But in the case of submarine, its weight is so huge, but terminal velocity we say in terms of something falling down, right?
So what if we take a...
So are you taking a case where a submarine is dropped?
No, so if we take a swimmer and a
runner. Okay, both have same mass.
Both have same mass, they're speeding up at the same rate.
Okay, so both have same mass. Both have same mass, mg is same.
More like...
Okay, now the friction here is stronger, here it is weaker. Okay? So for a lesser value of speed, it will achieve equal to the weight. This will achieve the same weight value for a bigger speed. This is for air, this is for water.
Okay.
I didn't.
You are not considering.
No,
you're not getting it. Listen. Now let me explain.
I got your point.
Friction is proportional to speed. The proportionality constant would be bigger here. Say kV. Here it is?
LV.
Small kV. So for the same speed, the friction force here is weaker in air. But in water, the friction would be stronger. So for a less value of speed, its friction value will equal the weight. So the terminal velocity actually will be lesser in this case. Are you getting it?
But sir, I have a question.
Yeah.
But sir, they're speeding up at the same rate.
Yeah, so it will achieve terminal velocity and stop speeding up at a lower value, say at 5 meter per second. This will stop speeding up at, say, 10 meter per second. Because only then the friction will be equal to the weight.
Yeah, and the resistance of friction is different will be.
Very good question. Any other questions based on this?
What is KV?
Yeah, good question, but bolo internals bada dena.
Internals is a continuous assessment based on your submissions.
Yes.
And I have shown you the marks.
Sir,
yes.
What is KV?
k is just a proportionally constant. You remember I said the drag force is proportional to the speed of the object. Faster it moves, more the friction. So the proportionality constant, if you multiply, you will get the equation. Yes.
So supposedly we take a case of a stone falling from, supposedly I drop a stone from the top of this building. So obviously due to it has a fine amount of mass, okay, so it's falling. So now that the friction starts acting more as it's coming down, it's accelerating more, okay, right, sir? So when will it
accelerate? Accelerating more? What do you mean accelerating more?
So like it's experiencing a force, right? It's
acceleration is given by the net force.
It's experiencing.
Net force will keep decreasing as the air resistance increases due to the increasing speed. Finally, it will reach terminal velocity and fall with same speed. So actually this experiment has been done. Like people try to set the Guinness record for catching a ball dropped from maximum possible height. Okay? So somebody tried to catch a watermelon, okay, from a great height. Actually what happened? Yeah, he was supposed to drop something. So just to play a prank, that guy from the helicopter, he dropped a watermelon or some other red colored fruit. So when trying to catch it, he missed and it landed on his head.
Dead.
Splashed in red colored, all the pulp and everything. And that guy thought his head only exploded. And he said, in the screen, oh, my head exploded, I'm dead.
What?
Under
this,
the guy actually said the
word. What is anyway related to the subject?
Terminal velocity.
Terminal velocity is that.
So, for watermelon falling from such a great height, should have actually made his head explode.
So, the head was such that his head didn't, the height was such that
no, no,
head did not explode. So, here's the story. So, the actual record which was set, okay, I don't remember the height, but he set it at the cost of what happened is he caught the ball. And then due to the impact, his hand hit his face, his jaw broke, most of his teeth also fell off. And finally he held on to it and set the record.
I have a question. Can I use the board?
Yeah. Okay, how much time is it?
Yeah, I know. 10 minutes.
Yeah, okay. So
wait,
12 minutes.
So
this is a stone from the top of the building. So here the net force equals to 0.
Okay.
So sir, this and this is the ground.
Yeah.
Okay, sir.
Yeah.
So this thing would be terminal velocity.
Yes.
But sir, here the only force acting upon it was this force, mg.
No, mg and air resistance both are acting. Both are cancelled out.
Both are cancelled out. So sir, which force makes it to fall this?
You don't need any force to move with a speed. Newton's first law. Forgot.
Inertia.
Inertia of motion. Inertia of rest. You don't need a force.
I think we need to ask you.
Sir,
I am smart. Sir, this is cancelled with a speed.
Sir, I am going to ask you. Sir, I am going to ask you.
Oh, yeah, it's just for explanation.